just to let Chet know, he really likes Blast Corps.
It's a good game.
It is a good game.
I actually, you know what? I make a lot of DSP. I've made a couple DSP jokes during the marathon so far. DSP, Darkside Phil, finally played Blast Corps, and he played it on the Rare Replay anthology, and he fucked it up really bad, and I got really mad, and I had to do it. If you go on YouTube and you do a search for "This is how you don't play Blast Corps," you can see my handiwork of Phil ruining everything.
Yes.
This game is magical. This game is fantastic. All right, your game. So here's what we're gonna do. There's a ton of stuff to do in Blast Corps. This game is phenomenal. This is Rareware right before they hit their gold streak. This is the one that people forgot about. Highly recommend checking this game out. There's so much to do in this game that we're not even gonna get to in this marathon. There's challenge modes. There's races. There's like tests of skill. You can go to other fucking planets. You just do whatever, man. This game is fantastic. So what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna complete the main game, easy, medium, and hard levels. I'm gonna find all the scientists for the best ending. That's how you end the game. And then I'm gonna do the moon stage, which they give you as a throwaway after completing Shuttle Island. So let me. I do have a route for this game. Here's what you gotta know about Blast Corps, because I'm gonna go through really quickly here. There's a missile truck, and the nuclear fuel is leaking, so it's on a calculated straight path to the detonation point, and you have to level all the buildings in the way of the truck so that you don't get nuclear fallout and blow up and kill all the surrounding people and stuff like that. So they give you construction trucks and robots, and you just fuck it up. Fuck it up! Yep. Okay, I know. I've, trust me, this is not my first rodeo. Alright. The platinum medal time for completing this stage, by the way, 11 seconds. 11. I think I was like 15, 16 seconds. Oh, it doesn't say my time there. That's all right. Okay. So then you have these mini stages. These are tutorial stages for different vehicles. So I'm gonna go through and do these real quick. This is Sideswipe. It has pneumatic hydraulic rams on the side of it that do this number. Not one of my favorite vehicles in the game. It's a little bit difficult to control, but there we go. You're about to see coming up in a couple levels here. You're gonna see the one I hate the most. By the way, gold medal time on that, 40 seconds. I did it in 19. Just saying.
Show us what you've got.
Time to get moving.
Alright, so you see J-Bomb, he flies up in the air, then he smashes down and crushes all the buildings. It's radical. He's like Godzilla with a jetpack. It's awesome. This game is the best game. If you disagree, your opinion's wrong. Oh man, I botched that. You can actually hit these buildings down one blow. Let's see if I can do it on this one. Nope, too soon. Oh well.
No trouble at all.
So if you know who Darkside Phil is, you can imagine how poorly he played this game. Also, gold medal time, minute 20, I did the mine 38 seconds. Platinum times is where the game gets stupid, though. Here's Backlash. This is the worst vehicle in the game. I hate Backlash so much.
Try this for size.
Here's why. You have to careen into the sides of buildings with the back of the truck. You can't just run into it. Backlash is very hard to control, and usually you don't get much room to kind of line up and take shots at the buildings you're supposed to knock down. Oh, shit. This little bump right here, though, I get a freebie. You can kind of do that. All right, here it is. Ah, oh, I missed it. Awful. Okay, screw it. That was dumb. I just want to point out, they give you 6 minutes to do this tutorial stage, and there's 3 things to knock down. You can believe that shit. That's a silver time. Backlash, backlash, shit. That's the silver time. Imagine platinum for that. Awful. At the beginning of this stage, you probably saw the little truck right there. Rookie mistake, if you just hold on the accelerator as this level starts, you will hit the truck and will die. Darkseid did that in his playthrough. I knew it was going to happen. It was the funniest thing. I was just waiting for it when I saw he picked the stage. I was like, oh man, it's going to be a good day. This is Thunder Fist. It rolls around and just smashes up all the buildings. It's great. It's the best. Booyah. So like I said, there's actually a lot to do in this game. I mean, there's things, like I said, we're not even going to touch. You're not going to see during this run. I mean, because you can actually go back and replay stages and finish leveling all the buildings. For exploring the stages, there's little satellite dishes that unlock secret stages, like that thing over there that says zero, because I didn't find it. It's actually hidden inside the castle on that stage, just in case you want to know. In case you want to know where it is, what's up. But, yeah. That jump. If you're paying attention, this was the level from, well, no, I skipped it, never mind. This is the level from the opening cutscene. But I skipped it, so it would not be impossible to see it. My bad. Ramdozer is probably one of my favorite vehicles in the game. Just because of how quickly it knocks the unique buildings down. It looks really OP, but in the later stages, you'll see that Ramdozer is not quite as efficient. Did I unlock it? Oh, that's a Thunder Fist training stage, even though I already used Thunder Fist in one of these other stages. Alright. Okay. See if I can do this. So this is going to be the first stage that has a scientist in it, so I'm going to have to... see if I can. Oh shit, that's dark. Damn it. Oh, alright. There we go, alright. Oh, it's such a hard car to use. There we go, alright. Oh, gotta use the bump on this one. This is a freebie. There we go, alright. There we go. That's a gimme. Oh, wait, shit, I missed the building. It's in the way. Oh, that one? Alright. I've made really bad time on this level. Where's the thing? There's the new truck. Alright. I might still be able to do this. Let's see. Alright, here it is. First scientist of the game. Gotta get out. There's a train hidden behind there, but to get to that, you might have seen at the beginning it said Ramdozer was in the stage. Well, he's hidden down here. Alright. Get out. Get in the train. Get in the train! Alright. There's the... Alright. Let's do this! Let's do this! Shit. I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it. The new trucks can get to the end of the stage before I can do this. I'm coming! I'm coming, scientist! Okay. Man, that's so hard to do. That is so hard to do. How close was that? Where's the... Is the level should finish itself. There it is, yeah. Wow. So I guess I had more time to spare than I thought, but... Yeah. That's 1 out of 6 sciences down. I'm getting them as I go. Alright, Havoc District. This is a pretty fun stage. That's the one I think it is. It's not the one I thought it was. So that little buggy is called Skyfall. Basically, it functions the same way as whenever we're playing as Backlash, and I jump off of a ramp, and I kind of become invincible and level the building I land on. That's Skyfall's gimmick. You're supposed to use that truck to get some sweet air and then take out all the buildings below you. Skyfall actually has entire levels that are devoted to just its little ramp gimmick.
Nice work.
Oh yeah, this game definitely in Rare Replay. I don't have an Xbox One, but I was really happy to see that this game got a re-release for modern audiences, because it really got overlooked. And the fact that it was included with that anthology, I thought that's really cool. So if you have an Xbox One, you can get Rare Replay, you can get this game. Also, those were the easy stages. I think this is the Skyfall level, yeah. Platinum time for Skyfall is 4 seconds.
Try this for size.
4.
I hope this works.
I just want to throw that one out there. Oh, damn. Well, I've already messed up. Shit. Alright, I did it in 12.
You're just trying to impress me.
Oh, I got promoted! Woo, I must have got a gold on that. I got a silver. Joyous. Shuttle Gully. This is one of the stages that's devoted just to Skyfall.
I hope this works.
Do all the gimmicks. Hit all those sweet jumps. Oh man, hang on. I gotta let my nitro refill here. I got the hang of it. I know. We just determined that I got the hang of this. You have to say it again. That jump. There we go. Oh, I'm still missing part of that house. Alright, that building, I'm worried about that building. Okay, good, I won't. Truck is all the way back there. It's right on the bridge. I love that.
You're just trying to impress me.
So you can see this opened up a cobalt quarry over here. That's the secret stage. Alright, Tempest City. There is a scientist hidden in this level. I may not be able to get it in one run. I'm going to try. Oh, this is Ballista, by the way. This is the first time we've seen this car. It's a motorcycle that shoots rockets out. It's pretty rad. Pretty cool. Ain't nothing. Oh. Okay, well, if I'm getting caught up on buildings like that, I'm definitely not going to make it through. I got 29 rockets. Oh, okay, let me pick these up. Alright. Pick things. Alright, here it is. This totally innocuous looking part of the wall is actually destructible. And let's see if I can make it up there. Right here. There's your secret level exit, by the way. There's a little communicator. Get the scientist. Get him. Okay, got the scientist. 2 out of 6. Now I'm stuck in here. I'm just gonna go try to finish the stage, I guess. Oh, never mind. The truck finished it for me. Even though there's a fence there, it's still... Whatever, that's the end of the stage. Blast Core. I'm not sure what all the games are on the Rare Replay Collection. This is definitely one of them. There's a glitch you can do in this game to save time that will automatically level a building in the English version only. It doesn't work in the Japanese version, which is much harder. I own a copy of it. I have not yet been able to master it. I'm not gonna do the cheat on this stage, but there is going to be a level where I'm going to have to do it. And that's so that I can get the scientist in all in one go. So here's Ramdozer again. Then there's a giant building right there, right in front of it. Not this thing. It's a portable thing. But Ramdozer is not going to be able to actually break that building down. So you have to use TNT for this, which means you got to get in the crane and get Ramdozer up, lower him down, get out of the train. Get out of the crane. Also, yes, train at the beginning of the stage. That's not the last time you're going to be seeing a train this game. Alright, now you get from the Ramdozer. Now you get to the TNT. Now you push the TNT into this building and blows up the whole building.
Nice work.
That game kind of introduces you into the concept of using the crane as well as pushing TNT into buildings using the bulldozer, because that becomes a staple of later levels. This is Echo Marshes. Like, I think this level exists solely to give you some of the hidden parts in the game, which is what Sportsman Babaron does. By the way, train. Alrighty, Aldina, thank you for tuning in. Good night. Appreciate it. Afresh. So you have to drive the train all the way out here and stop it. That way it covers up the... That way the bridge, it makes a bridge so that the missile truck can get over that little thing. And then they give you this muscle car to... get back to your robot. Play some hot bass selection of you. Get warm. There we go. Nice. By the way, you thought the train was cool. There's a fucking boat, too. There you go. Boat, whole boat. How does that tickle your fancy? Look at that. Also, you have to go in reverse on this boat to make it go forward. You press A, you're gonna drive in the wrong direction. It skips tits. Alright, and actually when you get out, it automatically puts you in the American car. That plays the general lead horn when you do it. Alright. So there's a satellite dish right back behind me where I just was. If you see this little path up here, if you fly all... Maybe I'll hit it this time. Probably not. Oh, no, not first try, but there's another dish up there. Skips tips. There we go.
Nice work.
A boat! Holy fuck!
You guys are freaking out about that boat. I got promoted. Oh boy. Can't wait. My promotion. Decorate again. All the badges. Alright. Thunder Fist.
Show us what you've got.
I hope this works.
Oh, really? If you listen really closely to the song, it doesn't play long enough in this stage, but there's a growl that's hidden in the song. And I hear it every time I hear it, it pisses me off. Bothers me. Cromwell Court, this is Thunder Fist, time to shine.
You can do this.
Also, I think the cash that keeps coming up is property damage, but that doesn't make any sense because I'm getting 40,000 for knocking down these giant buildings, but those little red flags over there are worth $1 million. No joke. There we go. Path clear.
Nice work.
Straight past. I like how there's a part in the trees right there too, just a reflection there. This has been easy so far. Ironstone Mine, there's another scientist here. But we're gonna have to double back and do the stage again because there's not enough time for me to get to the scientist and also complete the stage. Also, sideswipe. This truck turns really weird. I don't really like it. It's only this half of the building you have to destroy. Those other townhouses are off. Well, I mean, they're not mission critical enough. Alright. So we're done with sideswipe. It's time to bring out Thunder Fist again because he's just hanging out. There's some really big buildings to tear into here. So if you're a... Well, that was a crazy roll. So if you're a macro fur, this is all you, baby. All you. There we go. Nice work, thank you.
Nice work.
So even though the missile truck is all the way back here, it didn't even cross the townhomes, you'll see. I have to go back and redo Ironstone Mine, because there's just not enough time for me to clear out the level and also get the scientist. Whenever you replay a stage, the missile truck is gone, so you don't have to worry about it. You can take your time. It's all good. No trucks, just time for dreams. Ramdozer just parked over here inside of a cave. Here it is. I love that. That's something, folks that speedrun this game, they do the Ramdozer horn to beat the song. That's how you know you're making good time when you get to Ramdozer.
Go.
Which Mystery Science Theater film should you watch before you go to bed? What's the, Is it Space Mutiny, where it's like brick hard meat? Big McLarge huge. You gotta watch that one. That's the good one. Laser Blast is also good. Puma Man. Puma Man's a good one. I think the Blood Waters of Dr. Zed is also one of my favorites, if only for the line, I'm gonna kick you in the vent. Boomerman, he flies like a moron. This is stuck in my head now. Thanks. Okay, if you have to pick, Puma Man. Do Puma Man, or, fuck it, just do Puma Man. Let's get into that truck, get out, get in a semi, I'm out of here, good to go. Oh, Puma Man, like the cat. Puma Man is a fantastic episode. Ebony Coast, there is another scientist hidden here. This is going to be the one level that I do the glitch on. If you turn around, there's actually TNT here. It's telling me how to use TNT this early in the game. I mean, this late in the game. So there's a TP head back here, and normally you're supposed to bring TNT back here. If you hold down the Z button in front of a building that's breakable, so your guy can't get out, he'll say "do" a bunch of times, and then the building will eventually break on its own. The game handles, I guess, errors and stuff like that really strangely. The game does that. Hi, Missile Truck. The game does that so that you don't get stuck in a wall or whatever. But if you play as if you play around and you're a guy and you manage to get in the water, the level that you're on will quit immediately, and it'll save your progress. So that's also used by speedrunners. Also, if you read the text on the screen that blew by really fast, you may have seen that scientist mention a place called Oyster Harbor. That is my least favorite stage. A lot of people here that played Blast Pool will be like, "Oh man, Diamond Sands is the worst stage ever. God, it's the backlash stage." No man, Oyster Harbor, fuck that shit. Oyster Harbor is probably gonna be a level that takes me the longest amount of time. Where are we in terms of the schedule?
No trouble at all.
Yeah, I got promoted. Yay. We're on track. We got, what, 45, 48 minutes left in solo. It's supposed to be done at any time. We should be good. Ebony Coast, Outland Farm, there's not a guy here. Let's see if I can do the glitch, though. Let's see if I can do it. Nope. Shit. Oh man, that was terrible. You can actually glitch through the bridge right there, fly up through it, and kind of get a better bearing on the buildings you're supposed to be breaking. Yeah, because this wastes a lot of time. Backlash, tight spaces, don't mix. Come on. Man, you guys may actually see what it looks like when you lose. Or not. Taking it back. Jesus Christ. This building sucks. It has a stupid amount of health, or I guess hit points, whatever. So even though I'm hitting it dead on with backlash, it's still, oh man. It's coming. Googly Eye is coming. Alright. Welcome some more time. Oh man! Oh, that was a great move. That was a good move. That probably, if I was going to lose, that probably saved my ass. Alright, and then, okay, shit. It's not feasible to knock that down the way you're supposed to.
Nice work.
It's really hard. And there's the truck right there. That's how close that was. Alright, see you, Sal. Thanks for tuning in, man. Appreciate it. Enjoy Puma Man. That's the medium levels done. hard levels, and then it's just the final stages. Already through the medium stages. Alright, so let's see, Oyster Harbor and Glory Crossing are the two guys that were missing. I'm gonna try a glitch on the game to see if I can skip the credits, because the credits take a long time, so we'll see how that goes, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Also, train. Enjoy the trains.
Good luck.
Skyfall here, little dune buggy. Also, there's the truck, corner of the screen. It's so close to that building, it's right there. Oh, I got it. No, don't warning me. Don't worry about it. I've got this under control. I'm in control of the situation, don't worry. There we go, see? I got the hang of it, and you said that last time we had this. You whipped it! You whipped it! Oh shit. So if you actually ran a building with Skyfall's Hydro, it does a ton of damage, so it's a little bit faster just to do this. I'm not the best at it, but it is what it is. So here's the introduction of a new trap. This is the first time we've seen it. These appear in the hard stages, and they're a huge pain in the ass. There's just big gaps in the ground that you have to fill with little blocks. I missed that one, but that's okay, because this one's right quicker. Now, this one's got to go. This one's got to go all the way to the end, where there it is. It's hard to see, because it's the same texture as the ground. There we go. Whoa, man, that truck is going fast. I got a warning on that. What? It's way back here. Whatever. All right. Obsidian Mile. There's not a scientist here. I had to check. This is listed as a hard stage. I don't know why. I think it's because the cyclone suit is really hard to control, but as long as you come at the buildings from the side, you'll do the backflip straight through and take out the whole building. Skips tips. Breakdancing cyclone suit robot. I think this level is listed as a high difficulty one, because once the cyclone suit, once that party starts, it's really hard to stop it. He just goes. Once this pit's been opened up, there's no stopping this. I took soup. Also, you also may have noticed that this is a familiar-looking map. It is a repeat of the previous stage, just with different cars. That's one of the things. That's one of the gripes I have about this game, is that Rare did do that. They reused their levels, but it's still fun. They were just kind of hoping that. I did a heel click on that diner right there, and I destroyed it. I guess they were kind of hoping that if they put new vehicles in different camera angles, you wouldn't notice, but I noticed. I kicked the upper floor of that building. It's great. There it is. Open this pit up.
Looks tricky.
Here, one more. There we go. Nice work. Great back. Nice. I give it a solid 10. Truck way back there. It's covered up behind that wall that I just have to knock down. That was a hard stage. That qualified as hard, if you can believe that. Here's Diamond Sands. Here's the thing. The reason why the truck does not go around the buildings is because the story of the game is that it's on a fixed path, because it's the shortest distance between where it is and where the safe detonation point is. As for why it's going all over the planet, I can't tell you that, but that's why it doesn't just go around the city. Here's Diamond Sands. Ask anybody who's played this game in depth, they'll tell you they hate this stage. And you'll see why, but it's nowhere near as hard or as much of a pain in the ass as people make it out to be. It's a very technical level. So you can probably already see, you gotta break these little, these train houses that are on the train tracks that, for some reason, the missile truck is inexplicably riding around them. That's it. That's two sets of train houses down. And it's the same gimmick again. I will say that this level does get very sinister at the end. Rare does do a really... They pull a real dick move at the end of the stage. You'll see what it is. Oh, I got facing the wrong way. I'm gonna see how many of these I can knock down on the way, but I really should be focusing on this train house. Oh yeah, that was perfect right there. That was beautiful. That's one for the highlight reel. That's, oh man. Oh man, that was good. I hate the backlash truck, it's so hard to control, but when you get one of those, oh, when you get one of those, that's what that was. Alright, so here's the really sinister ending of Diamond Sands. You go through all these stupid things, you blow up all these train houses, and then they give you a giant building at the end that you can only break using TNT. With the dump truck that doesn't have the bulldozer blade, so the TNT doesn't, I don't want to say stick, but it doesn't stay with the front of the truck like it does for Randos. So you get through all this shit, you break five of these double-sided things that you have to keep running around under, and then you have to break a giant building with TNT. So I can see why people do not like this stage, but it's not hard. When I was a kid, yeah, this gave me trouble, but it's nowhere near the monster that people claim to be. Back and there's the missile truck. Oh, that's the survivors. I thought I could hit that. Yes, there are survivors in this game. When you drive a dump truck through their building, there are survivors. Oh, shut up. Don't worry about it. There you go.
Nice work.
So there's, I guess, Diamond Sands has a path. It has a course you're supposed to take. You're supposed to find out what it is. And the path I took with the TNT, I don't think it's optimal, but it works. What about the train tracks, assholes? It's a missile truck, though. I don't know if that's the optimum path for Diamond Sands, but it works. And as long as you don't have to be perfect with backlash like I did when I came in and got that sweet figure eight and took out the whole thing. Goddamn, that was amazing. You don't have to be like that, but as long as you're able to kind of ride along the buildings and kind of keep curly queuing across them, it's not impossible. People say that level's hard. They're just being a scrub. You want to see hard? This stage. Holy shit! This stage. This is the worst thing in the world. Alright, I'm not gonna bother with this. I'm gonna try to get the bulldozer free from where it is over there. Shit. Alright, that's good. Although that is a trick where you can jump off the side right there. The vertex of the 3D model is not perfect, and you can jump off the side. You can also take a people off there if you're good. Alright. So again, this level has something really sinister. Here's a crane. You're gonna have to put you don't put randos around the crane. You spin the crane around. Spin the crane around. You're gonna have to put a piece of TNT on the crane. But not just, and then you have to detonate that big thing right there. But it's not a done deal. See, because when you take this crane and you drop the TNT on it, you have to drop the TNT on a very specific part. It's third from the back right there. Drop it right there, blows up the whole thing. You drop it anywhere else, it blows up one of them, and you have to do it again. So, right off the bat, it's already stupidly hard. Here's another sinister trick they're gonna do. Remember those holes in the floor? Okay, well, those are back. So there's a square one. And no, you can't make the square fit in a diamond by turning it. They push in the shape that they are. So you might be thinking, man, I ought to put that diamond right there. No, you actually have to put this diamond over here. And then you go back here, and there's gonna be two diamonds. Because if you were to have pushed that diamond in that hole, you would have realized you were one short. Now you gotta bring these out. There it is. So I'm going to use that same glitch to get through this stage just for the sake of marathon strats. because there is yet another really mean prank, not prank, but mean trap at the end of this level. At the very end. Oh my god, come on. Alright, I'm gonna take out these building blocks here. You actually have to use the ramp trick with randos here. So you're saying, oh man, I'm missing something. Well, fear not. What you seek is actually hidden way the hell over here. Here it is. Here's the missing part. Way out of the way, where you'd never think to come look on your first try. You would have lost 40 times by now. You would have said a lot of mean curse words. Here's a boat. Like, oh man, look. Oh, but there's another boat here. But wait, there's another boat here. Right, there's three boats. I'm gonna do this the easy way, just for the sake of completing the stage for the marathon, and I'm gonna feel really guilty about it. But you got the randozer, but then it's like, oh man, you're missing the boat. So now you gotta come around, you gotta get out your truck, you gotta walk across this tiny bridge, and you come all the way around, and get in the second boat from this way. So then you're gonna do all this. You're like, oh man, this is so hard. This is such a bullshit stage. Like, okay, I'm finally out. But he didn't say nice work. The path isn't clear yet. What the shit's going on? You need to come out all the way over here and see this giant ass building and find out you have to carry a fucking block of TNT from one of those boats all the way out here. I don't got time for that. It's not happening. This is the meanest stage in the whole game. And people bitch about Diamond Sands. That drives me crazy.
No trouble at all.
I can't stand that stage. Also, there's a scientist hidden here, so we're gonna have to go get the scientist.
You can do this.
Luckily, we don't have to worry about any of that random crap. Where's the hammock? There we go. Right there where that ramp meets the top, that's where the vertice is bad. You can just jump off the side. So in order to get to the scientist, we're actually gonna have to go get that block of TNT. And to find the block of TNT, it's actually that first boat, the one that you're like, oh wow, they were so nice to have done that for me. No, you have to move that boat, which is already where it needs to be. So you actually have to skip that first boat, get these first two done, and then you have to go back to the first boat. While the truck is still coming, that's the boat closest to the truck. You have to hightail it all the way back, get the bomb, bring it all the way back over here. It's so ridiculous. This is actually on the Japanese version of the game, Glass Dozer. This is the level that I cannot beat. I think the timing is different on the Japanese stage. The truck moves a lot faster, and I can't do it. I get as far as the boats, and that's it. Good news is this is a long fuse TNT, so it's gonna last for what we need it for. So finding this scientist, I was told he was in Oyster Harbor. There's a million places you can look at this. Oh man, don't do that. Oh, don't do that. Don't do that. There we go. Just get out. A million places I could look. You have to take this TNT, blow up this thing right here. It just doesn't look like anything. Now you've made a path for this boat. Now you take the boat and you just go. You just go. And all the way out on this stupid little island is the little scientist with his travel trailer. Asshole. There we go. Hate that guy. He's the worst. The worst scientist in the worst level. Shit tier science. That guy's probably practices homeopathy. That's fake science. There we go. So now Oyster Harbor, over and done with. That's it. We're not out of the fire yet. There's two other stages that kind of give you problems in this game. Angel City is one of them. Also, you may have recognized this map. They've used this city for a third time. They put the dump truck in it, so it's a new, brand new stage, original stage. Do not copy. Because that's what Rareware said. They were like, man, you know what people really need? What they really want in this game? A bunch of tight turns with backlash. Oh man. I'm doing pretty good. Usually when I'm doing bad on the stage, you'll be able to see the missile truck whenever I back up. Thankfully that's not the case, so I'm doing alright. If only I had the cyclone suit. Oh, come on. Just break that shit. There you go. I get a bit of a freebie here because there is a little bump in the road where I can use that to my advantage and tear down some of these buildings. Try it again, see if I can get the rest of this red one at least. Alright. At least I have a road now, so I can kind of, well, not do that and get wedged between some buildings. But, oh man.
Awesome.
Shit. Oh man, I hear the truck. I hear the missile truck. It's like right here. Oh no. Oh shit. There it is. Oh man, he's got me. I lost. I'm gonna have to redo this. That's what it looks like when you lose. I finally lost. Finally. Alright, let's try it again. There's no urgency to her voice at all whatsoever. There's a nuclear truck leaking fuel that's heading straight to the city. Well, time to get moving. Okay. Let's do this. Ah. Backlash, please. That was not a bad hit. Let's see if I can finish the job here. Really? That little piece too? Okay. I got it. Come on. don't know if I'll be able to use. There we go. All right. Now we're cooking with fire. Taking much better time on this second attempt. Alright. So there's a little bump here. I have to kind of wedge into that. Use the bump to my advantage here. I'm trying. There we go. Use it again to level that building. That's a freebie. Then here's the shit one. God, this one's awful. The trees make it impossible for you to backlash into it. Still got it. I think we got this one. We got it this time. This is another game I used to play with my brother at FPS. Whenever we got to the backlash stages, man, that was when he handed the controller to me. My brother is usually good for the easier stages and the races and the bonus rounds and stuff, but man, when he got to the hard stuff, he was like, nah, I'm done. You do it.
Nice work.
Much better time, much better time.
You're just trying to...
Promotion? No promotion. It's okay, I don't want a promotion anyways. Ember Hamlet. This is going to be a repeat of Simeon Acres, I think, but there's a trick. They don't give you anywhere near enough missiles to actually beat this. That's why you have to break the farm right there, get the cyclone suit out, and open this pit up. Time for a party, man. Oh, shit. I think that's the only reason why this is considered to be a hard level. It's because I guess they expect you to be like, what? How am I supposed to do this? There's only 20 rockets. That's not enough to knock down all these buildings. You gotta pay attention to the vehicle select screen, man. It tells you the cyclone suit is here. That's all you need to know. Don't be a DSP. Shit. I'd like to meet the person that invented these vehicles for the purposes of demolition. It's like bulldozer? Alright. I'm game with that. Dump truck? A little unwieldy, but I can see that there's certain situations. Truck with hydraulic rams. Getting kind of weird. robot with jetpack supplies around. Okay. Robot that break dances through buildings. That's where I draw a line. I'm like, okay, you've lost me. You've officially lost me. You mean to tell me that the way this knocks down buildings is that this vehicle just gets down with its bad self and just jumps and flips through buildings. Somebody signed off on that in the universe this game takes place in. Alright, so here, this is it. Last stage, Glory Crossing. So, I'm gonna try something. I've never done this before. Where's the Thunder Fist stage? Let me try that one more time. If you exit this tutorial on a certain part, let me see. Okay, that should be it. So this will set up a glitch for the final stage, for the credits roll. That after I beat this level, the credits are going to be interrupted by the missile truck blowing up in the middle of the credits. It's a funny glitch. I've never done it before, so this is going to be a first for me. This is a very hard stage. It starts out with orange warning, as you can see. Although I am making relatively short work of it. This is also where the final scientist is. Okay, those who only have 5 scientists. So the 6th one is in this stage. The stage is intense. Plays the title screen music, that's how you know it's legit, it's real. Alright, only one part left in this house, it's just, oh man, I was wrong with this too. Okay. Got this. Alright, come on, back it up. Jesus. Alright. I've got time. Oh no. It's coming. Ah! No! Okay, get out of here!
Nice work.
I gotta hurry, because it's right there at the end of the stage. I might not make it. I think I made a wrong turn, shit. I goofed. It's in here. No!
No.
Please make it. Okay, sixth scientist. All right. So now when this stage ends, if I've done this right, the credits are gonna roll. That was the final hard stage. That was the final scientist. And since I quit Thunderfist at the little tutorial at a very specific point, the fake input that was being read by Thunderfist is going to translate over to my invisible character model during the credits. And if all goes well, the missile truck should explode in the middle of the credits. So here's the credits. If this has worked, my invisible character model is actually running alongside the carrier, and it's going to eventually go out of bounds. It'll pass it at some point, and when my character goes out of bounds, it's going to consider that a failure. It's going to detonate the nuclear truck, and it's just going to... And since the truck is supposed to detonate during the credits anyways, it's just going to do the detonation early, and it should save a minute and a half. So, I've never, like I said, never done it before. I don't expect it to work on my first try, so let's just kick back and take a break here. I'm gonna open a bag of chips that I've had sitting here, had my eye on them for a while. Here we go. HEB knockoff Doritos. There's other setups for this glitch that are harder to do. They're less consistent from what I've read. I don't think I got it because it would have blown up in the middle of the city, so oh well. Nah. It was worth a shot. Like I said, I've never done it before. That's the safe detonation point right there by that city you just drove through. Can't skip this. I like that they're like, rebuilding begins immediately. They give you the option to go into stages and level buildings that were not ever in the way of the carrier. You don't even have to, but you can. Okay. Here it is. Out of nowhere, in the fucking space shuttle, it's like, oh man, we're gonna have to do an emergency landing. So, there's just a city in the middle of this island you have to level. I want to draw your attention on the right. See that giant building by itself on the right? That's going to be key. Because they're going to give you backlash to start Shuttle Island with. And if you're like me, you're going to be like, oh, hell no. We're not doing that. Give you the dump truck. They give you all these buildings to hit with it with backlash. You're like, nah, man. It ain't happening. Come over here. There it is. My man. Thunderfist. Here to fist all these buildings. That shovel's approaching awfully quickly. Sometimes I get nervous like, dude, I'm not gonna make it. 2,000 feet already? Thank you. Those four kits mean that level's complete.
Well,
as in, you found everything and knocked everything down and all that crap. Already on final approach. See if I can. Ah, no. Ah, never mind. You can get out of Thunderfist in such a way so it's mid-step and its legs are apart, and then you can get inside the dump truck and, like, park it between its legs, and then you can get back in the Thunderfist, and when it tries to walk, it just spins around. I was trying to do that, but I couldn't quite do it. Okay, we got another little bit of scrolling text as well. Chips don't taste very good.
You're just trying to impress me.
all these interstitials, it's like they didn't know how to end the game. They're like, let's just put some more shit in there. Who cares? There's a space shuttle coming in. And then some asshole in the back of that meeting was like, let's go to the moon! So now, let's go to the moon. Fuck it. You've already got a robot that breakdances through buildings. We've already lost all sense of realism. Put him on the moon!
Get moving.
Also, for some reason, backlash on the moon control is just ridiculous. Here it is. See? Backlash, please. There, oh man. This is one of my favorite tracks, not tracks, like in levels, but in terms of tracks for like music in the game. It only plays during some of the secret stages. There we go, that's a good one right there. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Do something about these boxes. Except there's like one left, two left. They're stacking really weirdly. Alright, there we go. I think that's all of them. Did I make one more pass? Okay, good. Here it is. Here's the best part. Here's the best part. America! This is your reward for dealing with all that shit from earlier. It's like, you put a dump truck on the moon, and you can just level everything. Yeah! 360's on the moon! Okay. You can actually use these bumps to do this part a lot quicker. There it is. Oh! America! Oh man, that's so rewarding. After going through all these stages, just being able to play the moon stage and just jump over everything is one of the most... This is one of the most satisfying secret endings to a game I've ever played, which is one of the reasons why I love this game so much. Oh, come on, that was a hit on the... I broke the black parts off. Alright. Let's do this. Oh, come on. Do something about these antennas. These moon antennas. Yeah! It's so rewarding. One more building left. That's it. This is the last building of the game, and we've completed it. Diamolsis don't want to be over, but all good things come to an end. Congratulations! Again, you saved the nuke truck, you saved the spaceship, you blew up the moon, you drew a dick on the moon doing wheelies with your truck. Man, you did it. Congratulations. So if you go through all the stages, you get a gold medal on everything. You unlock all the stages. Then you can go to Mercury, you can go to Mars, you can go to Neptune, you can go to Jupiter. And if they're all races that have like different weird gravity and a lot of jumps. So it's pretty fun. Also, I just noticed that my truck was like halfway sunken into the ground. That's a wrap on Blast Corps. That's a wrap. Boom. Alright. Let me go back over to my system. Also, turn off the 64.